Domine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Celebrate today Our Lady's Assumption, Mary's heavenly birthday. Our Mass is offered for the repose of the soul of Tim Morrissey. Fratres agnoscamus peccata nostra, ut aptissimus et sacrament. Perduca. Omnipotens Deus, et dimissis peccatis nostris, perducat nos ad vitam aeternam. Omnipotens Sempaterne Deus, qui Immaculatam Virginem Mariam, Fili Tui Genitorum, corpore et anima ad celestem gloriam assumsisti, concede quae sumus, ut et superna semper intendi, ipsius gloriae meriamo esse consortes, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
A reading from the book of the Apocalypse. The sanctuary of God in heaven opened, and the Ark of the Covenant could be seen inside it. Now a great sign appeared in heaven, a woman adorned with the sun, standing on the moon, and with the 12 stars on her head for a crown. She was pregnant and in labor, crying aloud in the pangs of childbirth. Then a second sign appeared in the sky, a huge red dragon, which had 7 heads and 10 horns, and each of the 7 heads crowned with a coronet. Its tail dragged a third of the stars from the sky and dropped them to the earth. And the dragon stopped in front of the woman as she was having the child, so that he could eat it as soon as it was born from its mother. The woman brought a male child into the world, the son who was to rule all the nations with an iron scepter. And the child was taken straight up to God and to his throne, while the woman escaped into the desert where God had made a place of safety ready. Then I heard a voice shout from heaven, "Victory and power and empire forever have been won by our God and all authority for his Christ."
Verbum Domini.
Thank you.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Death came through one man, and in the same way, the resurrection of the dead has come through one man. Just as all men die in Adam, so all men will be brought to life in Christ, but all of them in their proper order. Christ as the first fruits, and then, after the coming of Christ, those who belong to him. After that will come the end, when he hands over the kingdom to God the Father, having done away with every sovereignty, authority, and power. For he must be king until he has put all his enemies under his feet, and the last of the enemies to be destroyed is death. For everything is to be put under his feet.
Verbum Domini.
Dominus vobiscum. Lectio Sancti Evangelii secundum Lucam. Mary set out and went as quickly as she could to a town in the hill country of Judah. She went into Zechariah's house and greeted Elizabeth. Now, as soon as Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. She gave a loud cry and said, "Of all women, you are the most blessed, and blessed is the fruit of your womb.
Why should I be honored with a visit from the mother of my Lord? For the moment your greeting reached my ears, the child in my womb leapt for joy. Yes, blessed is she who believed that the promise made her by the Lord would be fulfilled. And Mary said, My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, and my spirit exults in God my Saviour, because he has looked upon his lowly handmaid. Yes, from this day forward all generations will call me blessed, for the Almighty has done great things for me. Holy is his name, and his mercy reaches from age to age for those who fear him. He has shown the power of his arm. He has routed the proud of heart. He has pulled down princes from their thrones and exalted the lowly. The hungry he has filled with good things, the rich sent empty away. He has come to the help of Israel, his servant, mindful of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, of his mercy to Abraham and to his descendants forever. Mary stayed with Elizabeth about 3 months and then went back home. Verbum Domini. I have to admit that I'm not very good at listening to other people's sermons. One homily, however, has stuck in my mind. It was preached at Walsingham something over 60 years ago, and I can still hear the priest saying that yes, we should honor Mary for her place in the history of salvation, but that we should also love her for herself, because she was and she is wholly lovable. As we celebrate Mary's heavenly birthday, her share in the Easter mystery of her son, her Assumption, I'd like to explore that theme. The development of Christian theology is paralleled by the development of Marian devotion. From the early centuries, as the Church struggled to find the words to define the unity of the human and divine natures in the person of Christ, they found they had to draw into focus the human agent in whom that incarnation took place. Here was no merely passive act of biology, but an active ascent in faith, a genuine exercise in cooperation. Each of the Marian dogmas, the Immaculate Conception, the Divine Motherhood, the Assumption, her continuing vocation, which Mary shares with all of us, the baptized, as a co-redeemer, all these tell us something significant about the Mother of Jesus. But even more, they reveal the lengths to which the Godhead was willing to go in restoring humanity to its originally intended dignity. In Mary, we see the perfect example of our redeemed state. She is the archetype of what the Father intends for each one of us in turn. It is axiomatic that whatever we say about the Mother of Jesus can at least potentially be said of every other human person. Her Assumption, which we are celebrating today, is the culmination of an earthly life lived in the hope and expectancy of God's promises. Just as she had seen her son raised out of death, and been a witness to his glorified body, which St. Thomas had been invited to touch, so there came the moment when she too participated in the paschal event, transcending death. In our creeds, we affirm our belief in the resurrection of the body, the understanding that we can never exist as disembodied spirits, that we have a carnal history, which also needs redemption. It is the whole person, body and mind, heart and soul, which is to find ultimate fulfillment in God. All this is as yet beyond our comprehension, because it is beyond our experience. But Mary goes ahead. She points the way, as the Church assures us in her magisterial teaching. Mary's Assumption is both the promise and the foretaste of that personal share in her Son's resurrection, which is God's plan for the rest of us. In the 19th century, John Henry Newman was clear that any form of Christianity which fails to take Mary seriously runs the risk of not taking her Son seriously either. Where the image of the mother is allowed to fade, Christology is consequently compromised. Newman's words have proved sadly prophetic. And much of what is offered as the Christian proclamation in our own times has more to do with sociology than salvation, with the problems of this life, rather than with the answers that God has already provided. Perhaps a better balance can be seen in those many religious orders and organizations inspired by Mary's name to serve the disadvantaged and the poor. Think only of Mary's Meals, the charity now feeding 2 million needy children in many parts of the world, which came about in response to its founder's visit to Our Lady's shrine at Medjugorje. But to get back to the theme I said I wanted to explore, Mary's glory lies not so much in her own vocation, but in who she is. Not so much in what has been achieved through her, but that she is the first Christian. The poet William Wordsworth, in rather strange words for him with his own religious beliefs, describes her as our nature's solitary boast. Mary is not a symbol, but a person, and her personality is the guarantee of her child's personhood. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, living at a specific historical moment, in a definite culture, in an actual home, facing obvious challenges. God's self-revelation brought to its peak in a young girl in the backwater of Nazareth. Divinity has no more to offer than this. Christians remain fascinated by Mary because out of everyone who has ever existed, she was the one chosen to be the God-bearer. Out of the untold billions down through the ages, the divine gaze fell on her. God is love. And if God loved her so much, then he must have seen himself, his own nature, reflected back to him from her in ways that had never and have never been paralleled. Mary was open to the divine love as no one else has ever been. God saw in her someone who was worthy of his love. The wonder and the glory is that she is one of us, part of the created order, capable in her freedom of giving and receiving love. We love her then, not just for her role in the scheme of salvation, but because she is the perfect conduit of divine love, and therefore utterly lovable in her own right. Cardinal Newman was very clear about what he termed the sensus fidelium. Trust the instinct of the ordinary people of God, he believed, and there you will find orthodoxy of belief. Nowhere can this be better demonstrated than in the Marian intuition shared by Catholics. A statue of Our Lady, holding her child towards us, speaks more eloquently than any words of the reality of God's Son, who is her Son, of the Christian mystery of the Word made flesh, dwelling among us. And our love for the human person who is Mary will keep us close to the loving heart of Jesus, who is God. Marian devotion is a precious gift from the Holy Spirit, something to be accepted and nurtured with great joy and with even greater happiness. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may become worthy of the promises of Christ. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Credo in unum Deum.
Pater omnipotente, factorem celi et terrae, visibilio omnium, et invisibilium.
pray to God our Father, who chose Mary as the mother of his Son and wanted all generations to call her blessed.
Father, you did great things for the Virgin Mary and brought her body and soul to heaven. Fill the hearts of your people with the hope of their share in Christ's glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
St. John received Mary into his home. We ask that all Christians may see the beauty of Mary and understand more deeply her role in God's plan. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
The Holy Family bore the image of refugees and exiles. We pray for those uprooted from their homeland, that they may find security and peace in their country of adoption. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Jesus and Mary enriched the marriage at Cana by their caring presence. We pray for all Christian marriages, for those preparing for marriage, for those recently married, and for those whose marriages are under strain. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Through the prayers of Mary, our Mother, heal the sick, comfort the sorrowful, bring an end to the current pandemic, and grant peace and salvation to all. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Father, you exalted Mary and crowned her Queen of Heaven. May the dead enter your kingdom and rejoice with your saints forever. We remember especially James Flannan Brown, Mother Eugenia, and Michael Carty. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray with Mary, the Queen of Heaven and the help of Christians. In a few moments of silence, we open our hearts to God.
Lord, you gave Mary the strength to stand beneath the cross of Jesus, and you filled her with joy at his resurrection. May we share her humanity and come to share her present glory through Christ our Lord.
te fratres ut meum ec vestrum sacrificium, acceptabile fiat apud Deum Patrem suum omnipotentem. Ascendat a te, Domine, nostre devotiones oblatio, et Beatissima Virgine Maria, in celum assumpta incedente, quod a nostra caritatis in Jesu scensa, ad te iugeta asperent, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum. Tibi semper et ubique gracias agere. Domine sancte pater, omnipotens aeternae Deus, per Christum Dominum nostrum. Quoniam in celos odie, Virgo Dei para est assumpta. Ecclesiae tuae consumande initium et imago. Ac populo penegrananti, certe spe et solaci documentum. Corruptionem enim sepulcri, eam videra medito nolui isti, quae fili unum tuum vitae omnes auctorum ineffabiliter, et de genui incarnatum, et ideo chorus angelice sociati, te laudamus in gaudio confitentes.
Thank you. Quam oblationem tu Deus in omnibus quae sumus, benedictam ad scriptam ratam, rationabilem, acceptabilem quae facere generis, ut nobis corpus et sanguis, fiat delictissimi filii tui Domini nostri Iesu Christi. Qui predie, quam pater aeter, accepit panem in sanctas et venerabiles manus suas, et elevatis oculis in caelum, ad te Deum Patrem suum omnipotentem, tibi gratias agens benedixit, regit, editque discipulis suis dicens, accipite et manducate ex hoc omnes, hic est emim corpus meum, quod pro vobis tradetur. Simile modo postquam trinatum est, accipiens, et anc pecaram calicem in sanctas et venerabiles manus suas, item tibi gratias agens benedixit, deditque discipulis suis dicens. Accipite et bibite ex eo omnes, hic est enim calix sanguinis mei, novi et eterni testamenti, qui pro vobis et pro multis effondata in remissionem peccatorum. Hoc facite in meum commemorationem. Mysterium Fidei.
Omnia Domine, semper bona creos, sanctificos, vivificos, benedicis, et praestas nobis. Ipsum et cum ipso et in ipsum.
Est tibeta patri omnipotenti, in unitate spiritus sancti, omnes honor et gloria, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Acceptus salutaribus moneti, et divina institutione formati, ademus dicere.
Ademus
sumus Domine ab omnibus malis, da propitius pacem in diebus nostris, ut opi misericordiae tuae adiuti, et peccatus simus semper liberi, et ab omni perturbatione securi, expectantes beatem spem, et adventum salvatoris nostri, Iesu Christi. Domine Iesu Christi, quid existi apostolis tuis, pacem relinquo vobis, pacem meam do vobis. Ne respicias peccata nostra, sed fidem ecclesiae tuae, eamque secundum voluntatem tuam, pacificare et coadiunare dinieres, qui vivis et regnas in saecula saeculorum. Domini sit semper vobis cum.
Ecce Agnus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccata mundi,
Beati qui eccenium ani vocati sunt. Domine, non sum dinius, ut intres subtectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo sin arbiter anima mea.
Sumptis Domine salutaribus sacramentis, daque sumus, ut intercessione Beate Mariae Virginis in caelum assumpte, ad resurrectionis gloriam perducamur, per Christum Dominum nostrum. Please do take a copy of the weekly newsletter as you leave. There is a note on it about transport for London having a consultation about the congestion charge and how it operates in central London. You would be encouraged to take part in that consultation. The present restrictions and those which are proposed really are going to have a very large effect on the faith communities, particularly like us here in central London. So please make your views felt. We haven't been able to have any kind of social life together for nearly 18 months. But today, to celebrate the Assumption, drinks are going to be served downstairs outside the social centre. For those of you who don't know where that is, if you go out of the main door, turn right, and then go down the steps, you should find a drink waiting for you. As well as the heavenly birthday of Our Lady today, this weekend, Father Varley, who helps out a lot here, is 92. And then next weekend is Dora O'Toole, who's 104. Today is John Gilhooly's birthday. He's neither 92 nor 104, but we do wish him happy birthday. Dominus vobiscum. Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen.